Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. The paper is energy economics, and we are presently discussing different types of energy and their units. In previous lecture, we have discussed different units of energy. Today, we will be discussing the energy conservation laws. In the 20th century, principles of energy conservation were discovered. The most popular among which was given by renowned scientist Albert Einstein. According to Einstein, E=mc². So this reflects the equation between energy and mass. Laws of thermodynamics are very important in the field of physics. So let's discuss these laws. There are two laws of thermodynamics. One is the first law of thermodynamics. This law states that in a closed system, the total amount of energy is constant. So this law assumes the total amount of energy constant. So there are various forms of energy. That's all. Number one, mechanical energy. Number two, chemical energy, bond energy, molecules. And then third form is electrical energy, which is energy of electromagnetic field. And then fourth is thermal energy, which is kinetic energy, atoms and molecules. Number five, radiant energy, energy through radiation. If energy in form of photons impacts matter, energy absorbed or reflected. The absorbed energy can be further transformed into internal heat or transformed into chemical processes, for example, photosynthesis in trees and plants. Six, nuclear energy. So energy of mass, this is also called the mass defect. According to first law, energy can neither be created nor consumed, but only transformed. That is, transformation of chemical energy stored in fossil fuels into kinetic or thermal energy. The share of the stored energy that can be transformed into work is called exergy. So that part which can be transformed into work, that is exergy. Whereas the share that cannot be transformed into work is called the energy. So, and then the second law of thermodynamics. This law states that energy which is capable of performing work gradually decreases in closed system. So this law is a bit different from first law. So according to this law, energy gradually decreases in closed system. So this is the assumption. So which is also called the law of the increase of entropy. This law, which is second law of thermodynamics, is derived from probabilistic information about microscopic detail. So you know that there are two types of information. One is the probabilistic and other is the deterministic. So here we are more interested in probabilistic information, which is based on probability. So this law is applicable only to closed system, whereas the globe is an open system in which entropy can decrease. For example, through the scalar radiation or store of radiation in fossil energy sources. Now, what is the relationship between energy and chemistry? After discussing the relationship between physics and energy, now we move to relationship between chemistry and energy. So chemical energy view is based on the physical principles of energy conversion. An important chemical transformation process is convection oxidation. The result of this so-called oxothermic process is molecules with lower bond energy, known as Coulomb force, compared to the bond energy of original molecules. Example of these transformation processes are the oxidation of carbon, C atom, and hydrogen, that is H atom. Here, 1 kg carbon plus 2.7 kg oxygen gives 3.7 kg carbon dioxide plus 32.8 × 10⁶ joule. So energy is released here when we combine carbon and oxygen at certain proportion. So carbon dioxide is released and some quantity of energy is also released. Similarly, 1 kg of hydrogen plus 7.9 kg of oxygen when react, when these are combined, then 8.9 kg of water plus 142 × 10⁶ joules of energy is released. So many chemical processes only take place if energy is added, which is called the endothermic process. The system reforming of natural gas, methane to hydrogen, the following chemical reaction takes place. 1 kilogram methane plus 2.2 kg water plus 115.8 × 10⁶ joules gives 2.7 kg carbon dioxide plus 0.5 kg hydrogen. So this is a converse. Here we add the quantity of energy in order to get specific amount of carbon dioxide or hydrogen. Hence, the production of 1 kg hydrogen through steam reforming calls for an energy input of 31.6 × 10⁶ and release of 5.4 kg carbon dioxide. Thank you very much.